Hi friends, my name is Dhanaraj Chalawadi. I am from Bangalore. Now I am going to give you a brief information and some interesting facts about the famous author, essayist, novelist Jean Rhys, Ella Gwendoline Rhys Williams. Jean Rhys was a mid-20th century novelist born and grew up in the Caribbean island of Dominica. Is best known for her novel Wide Sargasso Sea, 1966, written as a prequel to Charlotte Bronte's Jane Eyre. Born on 24 August in 1890, Rosso, Dominica, British West Indies, died 14th May 1979, aged 88, Devon, England. Occupation: novelist, short story writer, essayist. Dominican nationality: genre, modernism and postmodernism. Rhys was born on August 24 in 1890, Rosso, Dominica, in the West Indies, where slavery was not abolished until 1834. After she openly advocated the rights of its black population and criticized its white ruling class, Rhys was popularly classed as socialist Gwen. In the 1920s, while Rhys was staying in Paris, she had an amorous affair with the writer Ford Madox Ford, while the latter was already married to the painter Stella Bowen. He encouraged Rhys to keep writing. Their affair lasted for a year and a half, and possibly resulted in Rhys figuring as Lola Porter in Ford's 1932 novel When the Wicked Man. Rhys became involved in a complicated and, by her own account, abusive relationship with Ford and his mistress Stella Bowen. She wrote about this relationship in her first novel, Quartet, published in 1929. When the affair ended, she returned for a short time to her husband and daughter. When Langlet and Rhys separated, Rhys left Marioni in her father's care. Though her affair with Ford Madox Ford helped to end her marriage and brought her much unhappiness and pain, the encounter nonetheless allowed Rhys entry into the contemporary literary world. Her career as a writer was finally launched. Jean Rhys got the idea for her famous novel Wide Sargasso Sea, 1966, after reading a copy of Jane Eyre that her husband had given to her as a birthday present. The first version of the novel was called Le Revenant, and Rhys burnt its manuscript after a row with her husband. After that, she thought of calling it The First Mistress Rochester, with profound apologies to Charlotte Bronte and a deep courtesy to. During her lifetime, Rhys had three husbands, two of whom eventually ended up in jail. In 1919, she married the journalist and songwriter Jean Langlet, who was imprisoned in 1924 for illegal financial transactions. Her third husband, the solicitor Max Hemmer, spent much of the time they were married in prison, probably for similar offenses. In 1949, Rhys herself, who had by then become addicted to alcohol, was arrested for assaulting her neighbors. Rhys had a knack for disappearing into obscurity for long periods of time. In the media, she was referred to as dead several times before her actual passing in 1979. A literary advisor to the publishing house, Andrew Deutsch, having been told that the author had recently died in a sanatorium in 1950, referred to her in an article as the late Jean Rhys, while the BBC once declared that she had died during the war. Alone with her despair, Rhys began to write diaries and notebooks regarding her emotional states. It was her first attempt since she was a girl in Dominica to order her experience through writing. In the voice of Julia, the protagonist of her second novel, after leaving Mr. Mackenzie, Rhys wrote, "I knew that if I could get to the end of what I was feeling, it would be the truth about myself and about the world and about everything that one puzzles and faints about all the time." Rhys packed these notebooks away in the bottom of an old suitcase, and they remained hidden for years. But the idea of writing had taken hold. By 1950, luck had changed for Rhys when she answered an advertisement placed by Selma Vaz Diaz, an actress who had adapted Good Morning Midnight for the radio, and needed Rhys' permission to perform it. The BBC initially rejected the adaptation, and Good Morning Midnight was not broadcast until 1957. At that time, Rhys once again caught the attention of literary agents, this time Francis Wyndham, an admirer of her work, who would later become her most competent promoter. He was interested in gaining publishing rights to Wide Sargasso Sea, a novel Rhys had begun almost 20 years before in 1939. They agreed that she would deliver the novel in 9 months, but it took another 8 years for her to finish the manuscript. Wide Sargasso Sea, a retelling of Charlotte Bronte's Jane Eyre from the perspective of Bertha Mason, Rochester's mad Creole wife whom he locks in the attic, was psychologically and structurally complicated for Rhys. In order to finish the novel, Rhys had to return to the scenes of her past, to the island she had left as a girl and to the abandonment she had suffered as a young woman. The novel was a critical success, winning the W.H. Smith Literary Award for Excellence. Despite this stunning achievement, after a decade of obscurity and poverty, Rhys retreated further into the pain that had come to define her life. Though she produced 2 volumes of short stories, Tigers Are Better Looking in 1968 and Sleep It Off, Lady in 1976, as well as a volume of autobiographical sketches in 1975 called My Day. Rhys regarded her later work as no good magazine stories. She died on May 14, 1979 in Exeter, England. Though at times bitter and self-pitying, Rhys was also aware that her profound isolation intimately informed her work. "I have only ever written about myself," she once wrote, "people have always been shadows to me." Quick points about Jean Rhys. In 1979, incomplete text was published posthumously under the title Smile Please, an unfinished autobiography. Rhys collected papers and ephemera are housed and in the University of Tulsa's Macfarlane Library. In Good Morning Midnight, published in 1939, Rhys uses modified stream of consciousness to voice the experiences of an aging woman. In the 1940s, Rhys all but disappeared from public view. From 1955 to 1960, she lived in Bude in Cornwall, where she was unhappy, calling it Bude the Obscure, before moving to Sheraton Fitzwilliam in Devon. She was awarded a CBE in the 1978 New Year Honours. In 2012, English Heritage marked Rhys Chelsea flat in Poulton House in Poulton Square with a blue flake. Some notable works of Jean Rhys: The Left Bank and Other Stories, 1927, Postures, novel, 1928, published in the US as a quartet, 1929, After Leaving Mr. Mackenzie, novel, 1931, Voyage in the Dark, novel, 1934, Good Morning Midnight, novel, 1939, Wide Sargasso Sea, novel, 1966, Tigers Are Better Looking, with a selection from The Left Bank Stories, 1968, Penguin Modern Stories 1, 1969, with Bernard Malamud, David Plante and William Sansom. My Day, 3 Pieces, Stories 1975, Sleep It Off, Lady, Stories 1976, Smile Please, an unfinished autobiography 1979, Jean Rhys Letters 1931 to 1966, 1984, Early Novels 1984, The Complete Novels 1985, Tales of the Wild Caribbean Stories 1985, The Collected Short Stories 1987, Let Them Call It Jazz Stories 1995. Hi friends, thank you. Thanks for watching this video and keep watching. Please subscribe to the YouTube channel for more videos. Thank you. Thanks for watching this video. Thank you.